Whether you're nervous or excited for uni, most of you are in the same position. It's going to be your first time moving away from home, so you're going to need to pack. Some of you will have a decent idea of what you need, and some of you won't know where to start. Either way, I've created an incredibly helpful guide on what you do and don't need to take. However confident you may feel, I can almost guarantee there'll be something in this video you won't have thought of. So let's jump right in. Bedroom. In the bedroom, you'll need a duvet cover, two pillows, two pillowcases, a fitted mattress cover, an undersheet, and maybe a blanket and a teddy. Though unis are usually really unhelpful, at the very least, they should tell you the size of your bed, which is important. One thing I will mention is that unless you've got a double bed, it may not be worth buying new sheets if you have spares at home. From my observations, most student houses have double beds, and you'll most likely be living in one of those for the rest of your time at uni, so it may not be worth having these for only a year. In terms of quantity, don't take more than one duvet. Not worth it. The heating's going to be shit, but a medium tog duvet is best in my opinion. And if you get cold a lot, take a blanket. Also bear in mind that you'll probably be there from September to June, so you'll miss the hotter months, and won't need multiple types of duvet. I got by fine in first year with only one set of sheets. You take them off, wash them, dry them, then put them back on in the same day. I don't see why you'd need more, unless maybe you urgently need to hide a questionable stain or something. I won't ask. On that topic, random bit of advice. Don't use a blacklight in any of the rooms, because 50 years worth of people have contributed to making it look like a disco. Why there are stains on the walls and ceilings is beyond me. Take an alarm clock if, like me, you sleep through the iPhone ones. Missing a lecture here and there isn't the end of the world, but sleeping through the one-off vital one can be detrimental. I'd say don't bother with a lamp, unless you want to be edgy like me and have a lava lamp you never switch on because it takes hours to warm up. Some people get LED strips. These are usually banned, so be careful. They tend to take paint off the wall. Bathroom. I had an ensuite, so this may vary slightly if you have a shared bathroom, but the principle's generally the same. In the bathroom, you'll need two big towels, one hand towel, one bath mat, a toothbrush, and toilet roll. Toiletries are more specific to you, but here's a general guide. Toothpaste, dental floss, mouthwash, hand soap, shampoo, shower gel, deodorant. For the love of God, please wear deodorant. Even if you're one of those people who don't smell much, just wear it. And shower every day. Please, I'm not asking much. Yours sincerely, a female computer science student. Hand cream, sun cream. This is an easy one to forget. You don't have to be as white as me to get skin cancer. Lip balm, skincare stuff, sanitary stuff, shaving stuff, makeup, hair bands, nail clippers, tweezers, vitamins. Anything you need if you have a medical condition. Your retainer. If you had braces, don't forget your retainer. I only ever use it once every 3 months or so, when my teeth start to make me look like a meth addict. But unless you want to be called adult braces, you're gonna want to make sure your teeth stay straight. Drugs. Your ears may prick up, but I'm talking paracetamol or ibuprofen. Some people have larger first aid kits, but I don't see the need. For me, injuries are either dismissible or something to go to A&E over, with no in-between. Kitchen. If you've decided to live in catered halls, I'm sorry, you've made a fatal error, my friend. You're only putting off learning to cook for another year, the food's usually shite, and it typically isn't three meals a day, so a lot of people end up getting Mackies or skipping meals. Probably wouldn't even hurt to take no kitchen stuff and buy it there once you know what you need, if this is you. If you're uncatered, you'll need two glasses, two plates, two bowls, two spoons, two forks, two knives, one sharp knife, one chopping board, one oven tray, one pizza tray, kitchen scissors, one saucepan, one frying pan, one spatula, one or two tea towels, two washing up brushes, two boxes of Tupperware, a cheese grater, a bottle opener, a mug, tin foil, cling film, maybe a can opener if you usually use stuff like that, and maybe communal soap as well. This is all the stuff that you won't need to regularly replace and you don't need to share. If you think you need more than two of each thing, you don't. unless you plan on being in a polyamorous relationship. You probably won't have much cupboard space, and it's good to have a kick up the arse to wash up more frequently rather than letting it pile up in the sink. If you're thinking, I don't need all of these, I'll just shove something in the oven every night. Your funeral. I mean, I pretty much did that, but even to boil pasta or fry eggs, this stuff's necessary. My random bits of advice about the specifics of the items are: get distinctive plates, bowls and glasses. This means avoiding Wilko. You don't want people accidentally nicking your stuff. Get cutlery without a plastic or wooden handle. It's much easier to clean if it's just metal with no thick handle. If you're a keen cook, take at most one additional pan. Plates which curve up at the ends and are a bit bowl-like are useful if you don't always eat at the table. Don't take any food. Dump all your stuff in your room when you get there, lock the door, and go food shopping with your parents. In terms of shared items, this depends on your halls. We weren't given any information, but it was implied that we'd have the essentials. We didn't. So between the flat, you may need one kettle, one toaster, and one pair of oven gloves. I'm going to be honest, other students live like pigs. These items will probably be destroyed by the end of the year. So my advice is don't take any of these. If you've got a flat of six or more, there's a high probability that at least one of your flatmates will have rich, overprotective parents who bought them every unnecessary appliance. And on the off chance no one brings these things, just get everyone to chip in and get them from town. You pay less either way. If you're a foodie, you can treat yourself. If you really want, take a toasty maker or an air fryer, but they will most likely get destroyed. These may be better saved for second year when you're living with people you trust. You'll certainly be given a fridge or two depending on how big your flat is. Mini fridges are banned in most places, so I'd say don't risk the fine. You'll also have an oven and at least one hob and sink. I'd say there's a very small chance you won't get a microwave. My friend had to buy her own. But I think this is incredibly unlikely, and if you don't get one, just carry it up and complain to the uni. Cleaning stuff. Maybe buy this once you're there so you can see what you're provided, but regardless, you'll need toilet cleaner, a toilet brush, but you'll almost certainly be given one, surface spray, washing up liquid, sponges, kitchen roll, and maybe reusable gloves. Some people take bleach, but it's no longer my favourite drink, so I have no use for it these days. You'll probably get a mop and a hoover, probably Henry. I've never been a fan of him, partly because I'm the only one who ever hoovers. If you've been told you'll get a cleaner coming in every fortnight or something, this is a complete lie. We didn't get a cleaner once. The cleaner was fucking me. A couple of my flatmates thought we had one, but nope, me. We had kitchen inspections every 2 weeks, and being the sub I am, though not where it's important, I was the one cleaning because the others were full of excuses. There's pretty much no point though, because the inspectors are absolute wastes of oxygen who fail you when the kitchen's spotless, without any explanation why. That said, be a decent human being. Please clean up after yourself. It takes 10 seconds in the moment, but will take hours once it's dried up and accumulated. Tech. This is an important bit of information here. A PC is not enough. Probably the most important item to take to uni is a laptop. This is also an item I think you should buy new. It will last you at least 3 years, and probably even longer than that if you're not one of those rich snobs who insists on having the newest technology every so often. I'd say don't get a hand-me-down. This is a very good investment. I got an HP Pavilion, which I've had for 2 years now, and plan on using for a lot longer. I can't fault it. Don't worry, HP aren't paying me for this. Given that it's such a significant investment for most people, you really need to look at the stats carefully when deciding. I've got 8GB of RAM and an i5 processor, which is good enough for me, but some people may want more. My priority was having a touchscreen backwards folding laptop. It was roughly £650, including the pen, I think. My advice is don't get a tablet. I know Apple have some fancy iPads these days, but I really think a real laptop is better and more future-proof. Also, and I may be biased on this one, but get Windows OS. None of that Mac bullshit. And if you're thinking Linux, get ready to be spat on. I'm sure for most courses it doesn't matter, but I do computer science, and most demonstrations and tutorials and stuff are for Windows, so it'll just make your life easier. And don't get me started on virtual machines. Some people take their whole gaming setup to uni. I'll say now, you can do well academically, you can game, and you can have a social life, but you can't have all three.
Is that supposed to be a difficult decision? Gaming and good grades?
I've kind of had this attitude in the past, but trust me, that's not a good decision. I plan on doing a video which goes into this in more depth, so stay tuned. Given it's very unlikely you'll have a TV, it may be an idea to take a monitor so that you and your flatmates can stream stuff and watch together. Also, nothing brings people together like Mario Kart, so if you've got a Switch, taking it isn't a bad idea. And get some Jackbox packs when they're on sale. Just do it. You'll thank me later. To sum up, the essentials are your phone and phone charger, a spare USB plug, your laptop and laptop charger, earphones, a portable charger, your smartwatch if you have one, your watch charger, and maybe a monitor. In addition, I took my Switch and games, my Switch charger and cables, my Switch dock, my Switch case, some spare Joy-Cons, my 3DS, my 3DS charger and case, and my electric toothbrush charger. There are two things I've left off here, because I need to emphasise just how important they are. I think the first is a no-brainer, and the second is absolutely vital for anyone. Take a mouse. You can get wireless ones on Amazon for under a tenner. It's unbelievable how many people rely on the touchpad on their laptop. In lectures, fine, you don't need to bother with the mouse. But in your room, why would you choose to not make your life easier for the sake of a fiver? Oh, also take a mouse mat. Secondly, take an extension cord. This is one of the most essential things, which lots of students overlook. And I don't mean one of those short ones which simply gives you more sockets. I mean one which can go across the room. I genuinely think uni accommodation is designed to cause the most inconvenience possible, so the plug sockets will be in the most illogical places. This will make your life so much easier. Maybe even take two. Clothes. This category will probably be quite intuitive, but there are some things I definitely need to mention. Definitely pack shorts, even if you're a global warming denier. Pack plenty of socks and underwear, because it's very likely that your clothes will get washed less frequently than at home, because not only are you alone, but laundry is usually expensive, so you'll want to maximise your loads. Maybe take a swimming costume just in case? If you're going to join the uni pool, this is obviously essential, but even if you're not much of a swimmer, it may come in handy on one or two occasions, though this may be something to buy there once an opportunity arises. Take a shit shirt if you have one, because plenty of socials will do this. If you don't think you'll go to them, still take it just in case. Who knows, maybe someone will pay you to borrow it. You may need white shirts as well, for writing on, but I'd say just get a cheap one from Primark each time you need one. Kind of random and probably not worth it for a lot of people, but if you already have a Halloween costume, take it. You'll only use it once, if at all, but it doesn't hurt. Definitely don't go out of your way to buy one though, unless it's October and everyone else is. Take something formal. Any kind of ball I've been to has been dog shite, but it's still good to go so you don't miss out. You can bond with people by chatting shit about the organisers. If you're a guy, a blazer's not essential, but at the very least, some formal trousers, a shirt and tie. If you're a girl, a dress. Before anyone spits on the ground, I'm not a dress person either. In fact, I only really started wearing skirts at uni. All I did was buy a piece of tat at H&M for £4, and that was more than enough. If you're the kind of girl to wear suits, go for it, but make sure you have something formal. Again, you may not be interested in clubbing, but I'd still say take something just in case. If you usually wear trackies, definitely take at least one pair of jeans. If you've got some really awful worn shoes, perfect. Some clubs are grim to say the least, and any nice shoes would get ruined. If you're a girl, I'd advise skirts over dresses if you don't want to be overdressed. But hey, you do you. Trousers are also fine. In halls, you'll need quick footwear. If you usually walk round in your socks or even barefoot, don't. The kitchen is grim. Wear slides, slippers, flip-flops, or even Crocs. You don't want to have to be tying your laces every time you want to get a snack. Hangers. Just get some new, matching hangers. Even an excess so that things are consistent if you get more clothes. I'd also suggest hangers for trousers. Personally, I think these are better to hang up than hoodies, so you can see which pair you're picking out more easily. Don't take an iron. Why the fuck are you ironing clothes? You're 18. My golden tip is to take your clothes out of the dryer as soon as they're done and hang them up immediately. Voila. Beautifully uncrumpled clothes. No need for an iron. In my experience, they only crease if you leave them to cool down in a pile. Take a coat. Obvious, but some people actually forget, because it's warm when they move in. In addition to all this, take all the stuff you usually wear. Cards. This is one of the most important bits of advice I can give you. If you can't drive, still get a provisional license. You don't want to carry your passport around every time you need a drink. Even if you're teetotal, although there's a good chance that'll change, you need an ID even if someone you're with buys alcohol, so you don't want them to hate you. Also, the other day I bought secateurs for the garden, and I got ID'd, so it's just a good idea. I would also recommend getting a 16 to 25 rail card. It is a godsend. You save a third on every rail journey. When I started uni, Santander were doing them for free, so it was a no-brainer, but I think they've stopped that now. I just googled it, and it says £47 for 3 years. Absolutely get this. I probably get the train once every 3 months, if that, but just this year alone I've saved £90. If you get the 1 year card, you'll probably break even after only a couple of short journeys. I also had this in year 12 when I had a lot of open days and D of E, and it saved me hundreds of pounds. Even if you usually drive to and from uni, your mates may want to go on day trips to neighbouring cities, so it's still likely you'd save money. Obviously, remember your bank cards and student ID if you're sent it beforehand. You may be wondering about getting a credit card. They can be quite a hassle to get at this age, so may not be worth it, but I guess it never hurts to start bulking up your credit score early. Just be sure to always pay on time. Take your passport. You can literally get a return flight to Germany for a tenner. Uni's more or less the last time in your life when you can travel during term time, so make the most of it. Just catch up on lectures as soon as possible. Don't do what I do, and not go to any from that point forward because you're behind, and then learn everything for the first time within 3 days of the exam. You'll want to kill your past self. Miscellaneous. Now, miscellaneous items are the ones that catch people out. People think that because something's not in a category, it's not essential. Absolutely not. Here's everything else. Earplugs. It's an unwritten rule that any flat should be allowed to have a party whatever night they want, bar exam season. You'll all hate each other, but it's fair. Earplugs to the rescue. I got a few pairs from Superdrug for quite cheap. One of my best investments. An eye mask. I grew up with blackout curtains, so this was vital for me. Unless you're happy waking up at 5 a.m, you'll probably need this. I've still yet to actually buy a real one. I'm just using this crappy one I got from a Delta flight 5 years ago. Does the job though. Also helpful if you like to be blindfolded for other reasons. A laundry basket. I'd highly recommend one of those blue IKEA bags. Some baskets separate whites and colours, but I've always chucked everything in one and had no issues. Bags for life. Definitely take at least two. They're necessary for shopping and helpful in general. Febreze. Absolutely essential. You can smell toilets down the hallway, and if your room's near the kitchen, it will always smell of your flatmate's awful cooking. Maybe get two so you don't get sick of one scent. A doorstop. I realise that plenty of items can function as doorstops, but don't underestimate the weight of those doors. They're often fire doors, so a real doorstop is best. It's a way to be open and inviting, and you and your flatmates can put it in the front door if you're expecting guests. Lock your own door and there'll be no trouble. A mirror. Perhaps the biggest shock of my room is that it came with absolutely no reflective surface. So on day two, I set out to Argos and carried a full-length mirror all the way back. Bit stupid given I had a bus pass. Maybe I was unlucky and most people do get them, so perhaps wait till you get there before you buy this. But it may be sensible to get one day one with your parents whilst you still have the car. blue tack and command strips. Your room will come quite bland, and it's nice to give it your own little touch. You don't have to be as weird as me by putting cartoon paintings all over the wall. Blue tack's great for figuring out where you're going to put things, and command strips are great for hanging heavier stuff, like mirrors. Pins. You'll almost certainly get a corkboard, so if you want to pin pictures or a calendar or whatever up, great idea. Decorative knickknacks. Don't go overboard, just a couple of things to make your room yours. Hobby stuff. You may not have as much time for your hobbies, but you shouldn't abandon them. A sanitary bin. Obviously only take this if you're a girl, but en-suites don't usually have these, because halls can't be asked to provide them if only half of people will use them. A hairdryer. I thought all girls dried their hair, but apparently not. If you usually use one, take one. Any hairstyling products. A hairbrush and comb. AA batteries. I find them more useful in second year because I have a Wii, a second year essential, but they come in handy when you least expect it. Just don't tell anyone you have them, or you'll never see them again. A water bottle. I thought this was obvious, but apparently not for some people. Also, this is England, so just drink tap water. Don't be extra. It's just fucking water. It'll save money, hassle, and the environment. And don't pretend you're a good person because you drink it at home, but it tastes different here. It's all safe. It's not like you're jumping in the river at the South Bank and swallowing some lovely, unfiltered Thames water. Grow up. You'll get used to it. An umbrella. I think I might be the only person I know with an umbrella, which I actually find quite surprising. To put it in the words of my mate, guys who use umbrellas are a bit fruity. To be fair, if a guy's hair gets wet, it will dry within 5 minutes. Mine will take 5 hours, and only if there's 30 degree heat. But I think it's a good investment. I got a clear one so I can see through it. Sunglasses. Whether it's my blue eyes or the fact that I never leave the house, I can't seem to see when it's sunny, so these are essential for me. A fan. I'm writing this in August 2022, so you can imagine this is my favourite item right now. But it'll probably just be clutter for your first 8 months, so either get your parents to bring one down later, or get one when it's finally hot. Cards and board games. Now cards are an absolute essential. Only cheap ones though, because they'll get absolutely wrecked. They're often sold out there, but Poundland do 2 packs for £1. In terms of board games, if you've got spares lying around at home, absolutely take some. Especially if you're the youngest sibling and they'd just be sitting there otherwise. Maybe don't play them in the first fortnight, but once people are settled and you're looking for a bonding activity, they can be great. However, and I can't emphasise this enough, you must make sure everyone's clear of the rules beforehand, otherwise all hell will break loose. It's unbelievable how many people make up their own rules and play differently out of laziness. My personal recommendations are Risk, Battleship, and Cluedo. But honestly, just pack anything you think could be fun for teenagers. Hell, if you're feeling ballsy, why not Twister? Just don't take Monopoly. Under any circumstance. Just don't. You'll regret it. Something you definitely need between you and your new mates. Cards Against Humanity. Again, this is something to not tell people about until a bit later on, when you can be sure of their sense of humour. You don't want to be saying Savile did nothing wrong or the Jews deserved it in front of the wrong people. Also, if you have any drinking games, however shit, take them. I'm going to do a whole video on this, so I'll go into more depth there. A shower rack. Absolute lifesaver. There's a high probability of your shower being shit, and it'll be a horrible experience bending down to get your shampoo. I bought mine once I'd moved in, which may be more sensible, so you can assess where you can actually hook it. Don't get the suction cup ones. They can barely hold a thing. Food clips. You'll end up spending much less money by keeping your opened food fresh. You can get these off Amazon or from IKEA or somewhere. I'd recommend a range of sizes. Tissues. Stock up, because Fresh's flu will hit you like a brick. Poundland do Kleenex Balsam ones for £1. Would recommend. Sports stuff. I'm sure you're way ahead of me on this one, but if you're a racket sports person, take your rackets. I have 2 tennis rackets, 2 ping pong paddles, and a badminton racket. Societies will provide them, but take your own if you have them. and obviously the corresponding balls as well. Though be prepared for all your ping pong balls to disappear on drunken nights. If you do non-racket sports which need equipment, obviously take that as well. A bike, along with a lock, helmet, and maybe light. This completely depends which uni you go to and how close everything is. Personally, I can't say I got much use out of mine, especially considering I had a free bus pass in first year. Stationery and work stuff. I can't say I've ever written anything physically in the past couple of years bar my name, but I doubt this is the case for plenty of courses. My A-level CS textbook was helpful occasionally. A beanbag. I'm not sure this is a good idea, to be honest. I only brought it because it wouldn't be used at home. My dad brought it the next time he visited, though, because there wasn't room in the car the first time. You also definitely need to see the size of your room first as well. I should also mention that we had no common room at all, not even comfy seats in the kitchen. Leading on from this, maybe take a cushion. If you ever do study table with your mates, you don't want your arse going numb. What not to take? I've mentioned some things already, but here are some more. Musical instruments. People will murder you. Only take them if you do music as a subject or want to be in an orchestra. And only practice in practice rooms. A Wii. Absolutely get one in second year, but in first year it will take up lots of space, so stick to card and board games. A drying rack. These make your room reek. Sometimes it will take days for your stuff to dry, and the rack will also take up loads of space. Fairy lights. These are usually banned because they're an electrical hazard, though it's probably really because the uni thinks they're a waste of electricity. Extra furniture. I don't get why people do this. There won't be room. If you own so many clothes that you need another wardrobe, you need a rethink. Everyone will recognise each person's cycle of t-shirts. It's no big deal. And that's everything I can think of. God won't have let me make a perfect video, so surely I'll have missed at least one thing. Don't worry, if I think of anything else, I'll comment it below. Also feel free to drop me a comment if you're unsure about any items, and I'd be happy to reply.
What a shitty video. Are you saying that I now have to rewatch it through and write down everything you've said? Only for someone to write down everything in the comments and make your video redundant?
So that none of you do that, here's a summary based on where you should obtain each thing. Pause the video here while you're packing as a prompt, but rewatch any parts where you want more information. Whoa, you made it to the end. Congrats. Unless you skip forward, in which case you missed a ton of great advice. This took me a while to make, so like it if it was useful so that fewer students can struggle with packing, and even share it with your friends. I've only just started my channel, so I've only got some skits and rankings, but you can look forward to more videos about uni, including storytime videos about the stupid things I've done here. So be sure to subscribe!